Mayor Greg Fischer wants to reduce a costly and dangerous problem, overcrowding in Metro Corrections.
WLKY's Ann Bowden has details about his plan.
Almost every day, Metro Corrections is overcrowded by about 200 inmates. Now, that not only hits the city hard in cost, in the tens of thousands of dollars, but it is also a safety concern inside Metro Corrections. But today, Mayor Fischer announced a new plan that's already in action.
Some people might say, hey, just build a new jail. Well, obviously, that's expensive, and we don't have the money to do it anyway.
But thanks to two national organizations, there's another plan. Building not a new jail, but a new software program for Louisville's criminal justice system.
To help us see, identify, understand, evaluate our problems and the potential solutions that come with this.
The city is partnering with the Louisville Bar Foundation, Metro Corrections, and two national organizations, Code for America and the Arnold Foundation. Code for America uses software to correct civic problems in a year's time. In Louisville's case, the organization will build software and technology meant to link police, judges, lawyers, and jails together to determine who really needs to be there.
Well, I think communication is key. I think working with our judges is key, figuring out what is really priority as to whom we house in the jail. Do we really need everybody in there that's there?
Metro Corrections says about 70% of current inmates are awaiting pretrials for various offenses, but many are not violent offenders or pose a risk to society, and jail might not be necessary. The Arnold Foundation is bankrolling most of the project to get that kind of check and balance system going.
To reduce crime, increase public safety, and make sure the criminal justice system is working as efficiently, fairly, and cost-effectively as possible.
Now, each Code for America software expert will stay in Louisville for about 1 year to help set up a program that Louisville's criminal justice system can use to help cut down on overcrowding at Metro Corrections. Ann Bowden, WLKY News.